I am from M Connect, the church that happens here just before you. So I'm part of you. I've been here for years.
Ke monya tadileng M Connect?
I think since 2013.
Yes, 2013.
So some of you we have met in the corridors.
Babang kopani messaging mo.
I regret that I can't speak Setswana. I was married to a Xhosa man, unfortunately the Lord took him. So I speak a bit of mixed languages between Ndebele, Xhosa and Sizulu. I really can't tell the difference. My mother-in-law was Sotho, and whenever she was angry, she would speak in Sotho. So we never got to learn because she only spoke it when she was angry. So, I want to greet you all. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Yes, sir.
Yes, and I want to say the Lord has led me here through all sorts of events as the pastor has just narrated to you.
Modimo ongeteletse pele ka tsela tsa fapaneng o fitlhela ke fitlha mo ka jeje.
I hope this event would be an appointment that would help one or two also be able to go out there, stand on top of the mountain and shout, "How great thou art! How great are you, Lord!"
Ke dumela gore modimo tsa sela ka jeno ona le ba batlang go ba ama ba kgone go bolela ba re modimo o moholo ha kaka.
Just like the pastor has just said,
jono ka moruta sa tshulo,
there are things never understand.
In
my life is one such. So when they say it, I'm supposed to speak about signs and wonders. Quietly, I say I'm speaking about miracles in my life. Because my life is a whole miracle. However, you look at my age and you wonder, are we going to spend 5 days here to hear this miracle?
We put something. I'm
over 60. So the stories are many.
So the stories are many.
I had to look through my life and say, so many things are miracles in my life, including just waking up and being able to be here today. And therefore, I will try and limit my sharing with you to three components of my life. A life before I trusted God. A life when I learned how to trust God. And a life in the space I am now. They say the older you become, the more freer you become.
You know,
even in God, in understanding how God leads your life,
the older you become,
the easier it is to understand to give your life to God. Because reflecting back, you realize you could have gone a long time ago.
Yes.
So I will start before I trusted God. Listen to my words. I didn't say before I knew God. I said before I trusted God. The reason why I say so is because I was born in a Christian family. I was born to a wonderful mother who knew God. A mother who groomed us and taught us about how God takes care of our life. So in other words, I had all the foundations. We prayed, we fasted, we read the word, we prayed, we fasted, we read the word, we recited verses. If I was going to be preaching, you would say, "Oh, hallelujah, she knows the Bible." No, we recited
verses.
There's a big difference between knowing the Bible, knowing the
Word,
and being able to recite the
verses.
So I was born a firstborn of 7 children. Any of you who come from a kind of rural life that I come from, you don't know electricity, you don't know water, Sometimes you don't even know an actual toilet setup. However, this mother
pray
for virtually everything. When we are putting the animals together to go and plow, she will pray. And she starts plowing, she will pray. And she starts seeding, she will pray. And God taught me there's something in prayer because we never got angry. We harvested annually. And the little me believe the Lord provides.
Amen.
However, there was another interpretation I added to it. The Lord always provides as long as you worship Him. Your life is straight and okay and no problems. As long as you know the word. As long as you pray. As long as you're close to the Lord. I never thought that in that same life, the Lord is there even when you're having problems in life. Even when things become immense and difficult.
How it be?
Difficult to understand.
What's our crisis?
So that's the life before I trusted the Lord. Guess what the Lord did? And for some reason,
come
my
come
first
come
part of my life was blessed.
Come
so the Lord made sure I did well at school. And I finished high school at 16.
School 16
years. At 17, I was in a plane from a rural livelihood where you don't know electricity, where you don't know water, to a plane to Europe.
At 17, one another blessing. I do want to get a
scholarship.
I am Europe. Yes. Yes.
I saw in a newspaper in a toilet. You know how toilet newspapers are?
Yeah.
I saw that and somebody told me there's something called scholarship. Because you live in the rural area, you don't understand this thing. And I saw an advert in the toilet.
Odulani plus ngawu kusisi ntho tsena. Ke ntse toilet ke bona pampiri ya advert.
Into gold, into diamond, into wonderful sparkling things.
Maemo ngosi.
I applied once, I got the scholarship. I knew no one.
Ke applied ha wa.
I had never been to the city.
A ke so fihle tropong kana go emare ke se ke thotseng thotseng.
But guess what? The little me thought because we pray, because we love the Lord, because we know the word, we are blessed. I've got a scholarship.
O ba ne ke lana go ke a gapela, ke tse ba lentswe se ke thola scholarship.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you live a life where things are okay, be certain you need to ask if your faith is grounded well.
Only
temptations
will
bring you that
question.
7 years later, by the way, the Lord made sure the life in Europe was just okay.
It was a scholarship.
I can't send a cent back to mom and dad. We were poor. There were six siblings back home.
Six.
I knew what my parents were going through. But my mom wrote letters. There was no Google. There was no email. There was no WhatsApp. She would write a letter once a month to say, persevere, daughter. Continue. Aluta continua. You are going to be the road that you will see us out of this world.
She
never told me when my father was sick, or when my brother didn't have fees, or when there was no food. She pretended things were okay. She even banned my friends and neighbors to write letters to me. So I finished my 7 years. I came back holding a master's degree. For those that may not know, you finish a first degree, you do an honors, you do a master's. If you are doing well, the scholarship was paying.
How to sell us a hand out from first degree, honors, and master's?
Because I didn't know what was wrong.
And I know,
I would have come back home.
Give a hala, put your jazzy.
Because But mom made sure I don't.
Simpa mme a tsa bo nete ba ga tsebetse bohloko tsetsa.
Amen.
Size and wonders.
Ladies, up to that moment.
Kana ko yile.
Gents, up to that moment.
Brethren,
up to that moment. I still did not know that my trust in the Lord was not shaken yet. I still thought life was going on, everything is okay. It's okay, we don't have money, but we have food.
So now,
you come back home, holding a master's degree, you expect, everyone around you expects you to get a good job, to start bringing food at home, to buy a car,
master's degree,
to build a home. The Lord said, no, Doreen.
Mudimaga che.
No.
Che.
A full year, no interview. No invitation to any interview.
Also, the master's. How long is it?
I'm holding a master's called a cum laude for those that are in class.
Also, the master's degree, and I didn't the distinction.
No one invited me to an interview.
How long time is it for interview?
We prayed.
We
read the word. My mom tried to make me understand that in his own good time, I was losing faith. I questioned God. I questioned those that I went to church with. Even my pastor, I asked him, is it okay to ask God questions? I asked the Lord, I've prayed to you. I have obeyed. I have saved the world because I love the people generally. I have followed all that I've been taught in the world.
Get it all. So get to do it.
Where are you, Lord?
Oh, cry, Jolly.
What is going wrong?
Can you emphasize in Jolly?
I started asking myself, should I be investigating other opportunities, other ways of solving? And you know what happens? This is where Satan is sitting and waiting.
Kemo Satan awe emetseng.
Lo ya uya et how isangoma enje yenza kanjani njani.
Hey una isangoma ka
yena. Lo ya uya usugogo kuzibani bani ulo mnyama wena.
Gogo mangmang aka wetsa
njani. Lo la uya uya et sisi kathi wena uboni.
Omunga ganta uboni.
You are so unfortunate, your whole family is so unfortunate.
Obani la palana lo hle manona listing ya
wanyana. Here with a degree. It's a red carpet interview. I know someone who knows someone. But the Lord kept me. I don't think I knew that at that moment.
What was happening?
But listen. The day the doors opened, they opened.
Amen.
No one can stop what the Lord has put in there.
How do you ever see one song to my bottom?
Ungava is some woman, Johnny. You cannot stop it.
Ungava unlo, you unchani.
You cannot stop it.
You can be a witch, whatever. You cannot stop
what God has put. You pray to whatever God you pray to.
Our Lord, the Lord I pray to,
the Lord I know.
Yeah, Kimo Tsiba.
When you decide,
I'm your future.
No one can
close.
The doors
opened,
my brethren.
Mama Chabule,
I go through my sister's school. I did all the things that you can think of. I listened to my mother. I'm a mother's daughter. I never disobeyed
my mother.
So
mama.
I listened. I took through
all
my siblings through university as I speak.
Bana be suka ofela ka bakile university.
All six of them.
They
are employed gainfully.
Ba sebetsa ha mona.
All six of them.
Ba six.
Are graduates.
Ke di graduates.
Some of them.
Baba.
Are overseas. Four of them are overseas.
Ba muse. Ba sebetsa.
I thank God all six of them still know the Lord.
Kyalewa mbana ka jeno ba santsa na
tsama mo. Thank God our mom is still alive.
Kyalewa mna ma wa ka sa.
Now, you think that was the best trial, not to get a job? No. Then you 10:30. No suitor. No one asked you to marry.
Hey, I just told him you're
the end.
Oh, no, I'm not going to talk to you. I just told him you're
No one is even saying. And the word says, you see, I even heard with my own ear one of my relatives saying, you're going to get married to your books. Ladies, those that have turned 30, with no such, you know what happens around you. Not only the people, but even you as you go to
bed.
Normally, naturally, you think you progress to have a family.
Oh, expect you to have a family.
And there's nothing happening. That same mother would close doors.
I would want to really remember
her words. So I won't recite them now.
But
my mom will say to daughter,
Murad,
your experiences must be checked against what the word says. Yeah. If you think your experiences from
certain,
ask and evaluate what you are going through based on the truth you find in God's word. If you do not check what you are going through against the word, you may never understand that God is at work. Trust God to work in your life in the way you see Him work in the scriptures. Then, of course, the ladies that have gone through this. So immediately I relaxed, the Lord opened doors, and 30 I met my closer man, my wonderful closer man.
And that's
why I was wedded, a white wedding in church.
I had a wonderful time move over,
and I decided at that moment, Lord, you have had my back always.
Mudimu,
you have carried
me
always.
When
things were tough and I saw 2 feet, and I thought, where are you? It was your feet carrying me. I give my life to you. At that moment, I turned my thought process from thinking life must be fine, okay, everything must be good. If you worship God, if you know the Lord, things are okay, to understand that God is at work no matter the situation. So Lord did work in my life. Whatever happened in between, it's a story of another day, including being told you will not have children, but still have children. Including filling my house with children.
Okay,
I am the mother of many.
Yes.
While you say gave birth to three, I'm sure the lady I stay with will tell you we are always cooking in big pots.
I am grateful.
My last share is going to talk to you about the Holy Spirit speaking to you. Holy Spirit speaks to you. You can omit all the other slides and go straight to it. Do you hear me?
Yes. There is it.
So Holy Spirit speaks to our spirits through a number of issues. It does speak to us through scripture. It speaks to us through prayer. It speaks to us through conscience. It speaks to us through a still small voice. If you go to that verse, it says whisper. If you go to 1 Kings, it will tell you it's a whisper. God speaks to us in whispers. It speaks to us through dreams and visions. And speaks to us through other people. Well, now I want to share to you how then, after I decide life, Lord, you are in control. Through it all. Through celebrations, guide me. Then I had a child. My second-born child was born with Down syndrome. Perfect life to me.
Round.
And from birth, she was in intensive care for days.
His
whole total life, total number of months that he stayed in intensive care are 7. Before you think he died early,
he
lived up to 11 years.
He was 7
intensive care units. So in 2010, I decided I'll go and do a PhD. For those that are in spaces of academics, you know how the world pushes you to advance yourself. Yeah.
So I came to
a PhD. So I went to Netherlands. I wasn't going to mention the country, but I have already done it. I went to Netherlands to do a PhD with a scholarship.
Netherlands and a PhD.
I took 2 of my youngest with me.
Anka bana ba ba banyane ba
ba. The boy with Down syndrome and his younger brother. We had a lovely arrival, everything was okay. 3 weeks in Netherlands, I woke up to my son breathing from another bedroom. Like, you know, you can feel somebody struggling to breathe. I ran and I found my boy turning gray, like blood is not
coming.
I called my then supervisor, who called an ambulance. We were taken to hospital. And immediately we were put in what they call isolation.
Mwana angwa ka spiti ba spetlele ba ba bea plekeng e khitlileng ya bakung.
The belief was it could be TB since you come from Africa.
O batswa Africa ke re so mhlomo bana bana na gaga bana le TB ke ba
bea. That isolation unit for 7 days, they were doing tests.
Ba etsa di test for 7 days ba bitse go.
They discovered that it was not TB.
A si TB.
But they didn't know what it was.
Bana ba satse biki.
They moved us to a bigger hospital which specializes in children.
Ba banka ba bisa hospital se se
sa. We were put in intensive care again.
Intensive care hape go.
My son stayed in intensive care in that hospital for 63 days.
Mwana dula 63 days
with
go.
No diagnosis. 63 days with no diagnosis.
Bosa tsiba lo so biki.
They did what they call diagnostic operation to try and understand why this boy can't breathe. His problem was he can't breathe.
But Tata Bane Logo, Ahono, Mama Habasi Logo Bane.
Okay, everything else is okay, but the boy can breathe.
Ahono, hey.
So they did what they call a diagnostic operation. For those that may not understand what that means, it's an operation to diagnose a disease. So they get into a theater room, they put something in you to try and understand why are you not breathing. And they concluded, they can't find what's wrong with
my son.
In this country, if your child is connected to machines, or if anyone is connected to machines, after 60 days, they have the right to sit you down and tell you, you can switch off the machines. They told me, ma'am, 60 days have passed, you can switch off the machines. It will be a committee with doctors, social workers,
lawyers.
They actually then tell you, nothing is wrong with your child's body, so you can donate organs. Here are the forms. You can sign. When my son goes, you can donate organs. And listen to this, brethren. I answered. Not with my God.
Amen.
I really, at that moment, told myself, God is in control. God will be in control. Only God can decide what happens with my son. One of the leaders of this group, I didn't know I touched a very sensitive nail. Not with my God.
It's like fella,
the professor stood up, shouted. He forgot all the professionalism.
What are you talking about?
I have been running that hospital for years.
Can't
you see the number of people?
How many people
were
more?
Where was your God when World War
One?
Where was your God when these children in the intensive care? I come down. I let him go. Over and over, when he comes down, I said, Prof, with all due respect, I did not say, not with your God. Not with my God. Ladies, the Holy Spirit spoke to me that night. I went to bed, I knelt. Who was going to kneel when we pray? I knelt and I put my head on the bed and I prayed and I fell asleep. I think I was tired. I woke up somewhere with a name. I grabbed a paper and scribbled the name. I went on internet, I put the name. I discovered the name was a doctor, a professor, who actually has dealt with children like mine. In a country called Nicaragua.
And he diagnosed
that for children like mine,
when
you hold your neck, you feel something that is like this. It can, when you sleep in a sleeping position, it can stick together. And the following morning, I told them,
She knows what's wrong with me.
Needless to say, within days we were diagnosed, within days we were out of intensive care with a tube. Those of you who have seen a person breathing with a tube, my child lived with that tube. Needless to say, the moment my child felt better, I abandoned the PhD.
To be with my Christian brothers and sisters
that can help me pray and go through. Although the Lord decided otherwise later, 5 years later, tell you what, that child has shown, he had shown us what love is. Those of you who ever came to M-Connect might have seen this book. Every time a visitor comes to our house, you would hold the
Unfortunately,
the Lord is Lord, is God. Decided in
2016
that the lessons has been learnt
and
took my son. Not from diseases, but from an accident.
By accident.
Ladies, that is true. The Holy Spirit. Now I want to share with you the verse that the Holy Spirit brought to me. Pastor and a wife visited the hospital. After they left,
Habakkuk.
The story of Habakkuk is a story I urge you to read. It is a story about a prophet who was angry over things that were not happening well. Who also questioned God. Who also became so irritated that God is not answering his prayer. He even said, God, why are you silent? I have asked. Where are you? But eventually, in chapter 2 of Habakkuk,
chapter 2 of Habakkuk,
you will witness how he started to understand that God reigns, that God is God. In chapter 3,
Habakkuk
goes on his
Habakkuk fasted among the high. Yeah, 78.
So in chapter 1, the prophet demands justice. He challenges God.
O challenge Modimo.
In chapter 2, God makes it clear that his plans prevail.
Modimo o mo netefala tswa go planets a
ja etsa. In chapter 3. Chapter 3.
Mo chapter 3.
Reveals a radical change in Habakkuk's life.
Ebon such peto e kgolo etsa etse mo
Habakkuk. He pleads for mercy.
O kopa mahala.
Finds himself on his knees. He joyfully praises God. Habakkuk repents and humbles himself
before God.
He accepts the coming judgment. And he praises God in it. And in chapter 3, verse 17, which I believe is what you are
reading, yeah, there.
That has been shared, he then says, though the fig tree may blossom, the labor of olive may flow, it fails. And the field and yield no food. Though the flock may be cut off from the fold. And there be no head in the storm. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength. He will make my feet like deer's feet. And he will make me walk on my high heels. To the chief musician. With my stringed instrument.
Hallelujah.
In today's world, you may actually say, because there are no fig trees, there are no olive trees.
Does it occasion us on the fact that the fig is not the olive?
Though my bank balance is at zero. And I have none.
Kill us now, lead.
Though I have no rent.
Let us now.
No money to pay my mortgage.
Kill us now, shelter up at
to pay for a roof over my head. Though there is no food for my family.
Last night, the job against our family.
I lost my job.
Like last night, you came to work, a business.
I will rejoice.
Get up, like it's time to
go. Because the Lord is Lord.
Obana Mudi, Muki Mudi.
My joy is in the Lord.
Tabolata Lamu Mudi.
I want to live with you, Habakkuk, as a chapter.
Kabatokala Habakkuk,
I also want to live with you, Psalms.
Lady Pesali.
Verses
22
to
28.
Psalm
what?
73, verses
22
to
28.
Yes, 28 reads.
28 balaj.
But as for me, God's presence is all I need.
I
have made the sovereign Lord my shelter. As I declare all things,
you
have done.
So,
brethren,
baena.
Even you, the youngsters, remember your life is a controller who is at work always.
Even
when things are difficult, God is at work. The work that you can never understand, because God's doings are beyond our understanding. Continue working for your soul. Remember, earthly things decay. Money gets finished. Clothes get rotten. I don't know what else. Cars get in accidents. Houses, they can get bent or get the only thing you should be concentrating on is working for your inner soul.
So that lives.
Thank you.
Amen.